Hello, Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I render exposition of Matthew 21:12-16. And these parables are very difficult, and it summarizes what the purpose of Christ Jesus was of coming into this world, and what did he attain. So these are his final words. And Jesus went into the temple of God. You know, this temple of Jerusalem temple, it was the first temple of God. And there's only one temple of God in the world. You can't have two, because your physical body, you have one. You can't have two physical bodies. So only there's one temple, and this was the temple in Jerusalem. And that's why it was called holiest of holy. And this being the temple of God was also the home of Christ Jesus, Father. So that's why Jesus went to his house to claim it. When he had attained the age of, when he had come of age and become responsible to look after the house of his Father. And cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of men that sold doves. So here the people, because it had been infested with mammon, and the temple priest was mammon loving and put on silken clothes and all that. So here they were promoting the businesses of those people who make money, and they were selling money changers were there, people coming from overseas, they will change money for them, and also they were selling doves for sacrifice and all that. So they had turned this into a business market, which Christ Jesus was not happy. So he turned their tables and beat them up, and said unto them, it is written, my house shall be called the house of prayer, but ye have made it a den of thieves. That means the temple or the house of God is where you do the meditation and prayer, and while they have changed it into money laundering business, or they change it into a fleecing house to fleece people in the name of God. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. So Christ Jesus, although he threw their tables and other things, he was angry, but not to the people who came to seek his mercy. So he healed them and cured them. The temple priests could see it, you know, his works. And when the chief priests and scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying in the temple and saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were sore displeased. So Christ Jesus performed holy deeds, and people who were there, simple-minded people going to the churches, they were singing praises of Christ Jesus and claiming he was not son of David, but he was in line of David. His father, Jesus' father, was God, not David. So he was supposed to come on in line of him. The people who used to, David's people, used to be very angelic in the past age. In this dark age, he become sons of Satan, are the most satanic people. So he had to come among those who are most spiritually sick. So people of Judah tribe were most spiritually sick than the people of the other tribes. and said unto him, Hearest thou what these say? And Christ Jesus saith unto them, Yea, have ye never read, out of the mouth of the babes and suckling, thou hast perfected praise? That means he was telling them that they were angry, and they angry said, look what these people are singing praises for you, and saying Hosanna, Hosanna to you, and they are you are glorifying God, and they are glorifying you. So in the singing your praises, can't you hear them? The temple priests never heard such praises for themselves. So they were jealous and they were so displeased to see that Christ Jesus is taking all the stage or all the goodwill of the people. And so these priests were not happy. So they tried to speak out their peace of mind. And that shows, you know, how displeased these temple priests were on seeing Christ Jesus performing the miraculous deeds. The temple priests are supposed to be doing those healing and all that, but as they had become mammon worshipper, so the power to heal and all that was taken away from them. John the Baptist, he was an ideal Levi priest. So he had the power to do so if he wanted. So the Christ Jesus performed miracles, and these jealous and revengeful temple priests of the holiest of holy, they were not happy. So Jesus then told them, you already have got this forecast in the scriptures, that when he comes, then from the mouth of the babes mean once born, who are like angels, because they haven't committed any sin. So when you are a small child, then you do things unknowingly, when you do things unknowingly, so you are an angel and you are forgiven. So suckling mean that which are very young, you know. So all these people who are babes mean impartial people who will speak out what is right and what is wrong, and suckling mean small, once born peoples. So they were all singing the praises of Christ Jesus and glorifying our Father through Christ Jesus. So the people, temple priests, as they were mammon worshippers, they had gold and all that decoration on the temple. They have made this the house of God as a marketplace to earn money, and they made it people used to go there. They used to fleece them and put a millstone of rituals around their necks as the reward for coming over there and worshipping them. So when they used to leave the temple, they were worse off than what they came before. So they were put into more yoke, they put heavy yoke on it, whereas Christ Jesus came to relieve us of those heavy yoke and take it off and put us the light yoke of logical reasoning to have gospel truth. So Christ Jesus here is telling them that it's already written that small babe's mouth the praises of God would be uttered. Thank you for listening, and God bless you.